It's just week one, but President Trump has already taken significant steps in his vision to rebuild the American economy.
Yeah, big steps. One of his first orders of business this past week was the withdrawal from the Trans-Pacific Partnership, commonly called TPP. Earlier this week, I spoke exclusively with the CEO of FedEx, Fred Smith, on the morning show on Fox Business Network. He's a bit worried about America backing away from trade. Watch.
The United States being cut off from trade would be like trying to breathe without oxygen. It's an essential part of our economy. I think the decision to pull out of TPP is unfortunate because the real beneficiary of that is China. The real opportunity is to get China to take down their barriers for American goods.
And we are back right now with J.J. Kinahan and Holly Newman Kroft. Your reaction to that, J.J., because one thing he mentioned was 80% of purchasing power for the world is outside of the United States.
Absolutely, and I do believe that that is something that we have to keep in mind. The one thing I'll say about that is when I hear about some of the things that are being proposed, you know, politics is about negotiation. And some of these things could be said to be bargaining chips for some other things. Obviously, the TPP, we have gone and gotten out of that deal, so it's not like that's a bargaining chip anymore. But I also think, you know, the president's a pragmatic man, and you have to understand we still need a lot of these trading deals. If you look at a company like GM, they have 48% of their sales are done directly in China. You can't cut that pipeline off.
Mm-hmm.
You know, let me just give a plug to the show. I was there that morning. That was a great interview.
Thanks.
We had some very colorful conversation about the TPP.
Yeah, we had a lot of colorful
So if you're not watching that show, you are certainly missing something in the morning. But, you know, Holly, I sat there and I actually listened to Fred Smith, and then we talked about this off camera here. Isn't it crazy how the market just seems to not be impacted by any of these things that could create potential trade wars? Why is it? Why is all of this being overlooked?
Yeah, we were talking about that a little bit. I think people are really believing the president and his optimism and his views. And, you know, the first half of the Trump rally where we just saw everything go up since the election has been great for the investor. Also, like we were saying earlier, there will be volatility. The second half of this rally is going to be sector specific. It's going to be more company specific. Active management is really going to be key on when to get in and what to buy.
Yeah. I mean, one of the issues is the fact that people are focused more on the other parts of the economic plan, like the tax reform plan, right. 50% corporate tax rate, and the rollback of regulations. Gary, how many times have we heard from CEOs that businesses are so focused and have been so focused in the last 8 years on compliance, regulation.
Right.
They've been spending all their time, money, and energy on rulemaking, and now they're feeling like the shackles are coming off. Maybe I'm going to take that business that I was hoping to do off the shelf and invest in my employees.
Yeah, and what is commonly known in, when you're sitting down as a CEO, that's your new initiative dollars. Where are you going to spend the new initiative dollars? And if you don't have to spend them on beefing up your regulatory department in terms of legal and compliance, then you could do it on new initiatives. So let's talk about new initiatives. You said technology and finance. Where are the areas that you see the fastest growth as a result in the economy of all of these changes that are taking place with the administration?
Well, I think it's two things. Number one, as I said, finance, because it touches, they touch everything. I think one area that's really going to grow quickly, it's interesting, even though rates...
So it's not just regulatory relief. You see growth in financial services.
I see growth in financial services for a few reasons. Number one, for exactly what you just talked about, companies are going to look to expand. What do they need to expand? They're going to need money. And I think we're in kind of a sweet spot for them right now. Why? The pipeline sent a message, and the message was, we're going to try and take, as Maria just said, the shackles off. We're going to let you go out and invest. Well, even if we continue on this course of rate hikes, money's still really cheap. So we're in what could be a really sweet spot for the next couple of years for these financial services companies, because it's going to be cheap to borrow money still, and it's a different environment. It's interesting to me with the pipeline, with some of the statements that the president's made around employment, he's got momentum. Some of the things may not even have to be enacted that people think. Right now, the momentum of CEOs trying to move jobs back to the U.S., the momentum of things, obviously, with the market, et cetera, when you've got it, you've got to keep pressing and pressing and pressing. It's almost like, you know, in sports, et cetera. And hopefully the momentum can continue for quite a while.
Holly, I want to ask you about the pipeline business, because Neuberger is known for investing in the MLP space. So what happened with Keystone and Dakota this week, is this, how do you guys read this in terms of investing in the pipeline companies?
Oh, we're very, very constructive, very positive on the pipeline space. Our MLP manager has been waiting for these pipelines to be built for quite some time. We're pro-energy. We like the energy space in general, but again, that's very broad. And if we were to pick a sector within energy, midstream pipelines is where we would put our money.
Thank you so much. Thanks to J.J. Kinahan and Holly Newman of Kroft. More Wall Street Week right after this.